This is Lee Habib sitting in for Dennis Prager. Topic of the hour, first jobs. We've heard from Ashton Kutcher. We've heard from Mark Cuban. We heard from former CEO of Best Buy, Brad Anderson. And on the line, joining us now, Mike Rowe, pitchman, opera singer, narrator. You know him from Dirty Jobs. You also know him from CNN. Somebody's got to do it. Mike, thanks for joining us.
Timely. By the way, it's so funny. That song you're playing right now was my first choice for the theme song of Dirty Jobs, and we just couldn't get it because we were just too doggone cheap.
Oh, that's the way to go. I love it. I love it. You can afford it now, though.
Well, at least 3 or 4 bars of it anyway.
That's right. That's right. Hey, Mike, tell us about and tell the audience, Dennis Prager's audience, and this is Lee Habib sitting in for Dennis Prager. Tell the audience what your first job was, Mike.
Look, I mean, honestly, I'm driving over. I'm in a recording studio right now, and on my way here, I was really honestly trying to recall the first time I actually got a paycheck. Not paid, but an actual paycheck. And as near as I can remember it, it was by United Artists, where I was working as an usher in high school in one of the first multiplex theaters in a mall back in 1978. Black pants, red jacket, white shirt, terrible velvety black bow tie.
Oh, what an ugly image, Mike. Stop now, please.
Look, I worked my way up to the sewer, but you had to start somewhere.
That's true. So that's your first check, and pretty soon, what's the next job? What's that second job, Mike Rowe?
Well, I'm a creature of place, and so I like to wring every last drop out of possibility of wherever I am. So, you know, in those days, there was an actual path, granted, kind of a circuitous one, but a good usher who showed up on time and did his job had a shot at being a cashier. And a good cashier who showed up on time and didn't steal had a chance of maybe working their way up to the projectionist booth. So, you know, all those jobs within United Artists were possible, and I touched as many as I could along the way and made a little bit more with each one. Now, of course, all those jobs are basically gone because, you know, you can buy your ticket as well as your popcorn without touching a human. And in fact, you can run a movie nowadays without even putting those big giant reels, you know. We used to have 22 gates you had to thread the film through. It was amazingly complicated and sort of skill-driven. Now you hit a button, put in a disc.
Yeah, there's no doubt. You know, Mike, one of the things, and we're talking with Mike Rowe, and you must see his show, Somebody's Got to Do It, on CNN. It's terrific. And Dirty Jobs, of course. There's nothing more entertaining than watching Mike snip off bull testicles, for instance. There's nothing quite as fun, because you just imagine what it would be like. He's there for you. He's doing it for you, so you don't have to.
I was actually doing it because I had failed so miserably to credibly impersonate a host up to that point that it just became simpler to embrace the role of a perpetual apprentice and simply follow orders.
Well, what a wonderful thing, Mike, and I think it's such a terrific show precisely because of that point of view. You know, I wanted to talk just briefly, because the point of this First Jobs Fridays is the work ethic and what's happened to it in America and how do we reinforce it, how do we reward it. And you tell the story. I saw a TED Talk you gave a couple of years ago, Mike, and you were quoting Aristotle. I mean, the guy who snippets bull testicles was also quoting Aristotle, but this caught my attention. You had recalled seeing a poster and it was in a guidance counselor's office of all places, and it said, "Work smart, not hard." And what did you do to that poster, "Work smart, not hard"?
Well, it took me 35 years to getting around to defacing it, which was what I wanted to do the first time I saw it. But that moment, and look, high school kids are going through this right now as we speak. I was summoned to Mr. Dunbar's office to discuss my future. He was arguing persuasively for a 4-year degree, and I was open to it. I just didn't have any money, and I didn't know what I wanted to do, so I told him that a 2-year school seemed more affordable and more likely, at which point he pointed to this poster, and the images on the poster, it was split down the middle. On the left is a kid holding a college degree, looking hopeful and optimistically toward the future. On the right is a mechanic, head down, covered in crap, or something worse, holding a wrench, looking like he just won the vocational consolation prize of all time. And it was the caption, though, Lee, honestly, "Work smart, not hard." It was the first time I'd seen it. And that poster and that sentiment in the late 70s was actually part of a larger PR campaign designed to get kids excited about higher education. Unfortunately, it came at the expense of all other forms of education. And my own personal theory, for what it's worth, is that our country has taken that advice. If you Google "work smart, not hard" right now, you'll see hundreds of pages. It's a platitude that has inculcated itself deep into the country's brainstem, and it's a false choice. You know, work smart and hard. Last year, I did a campaign with Caterpillar around a work ethic issue, around a recruitment issue, and I recreated the poster, and I crossed out "not," and I scratched in "and," and we've since sold a few thousand of them, and now they're hanging in high schools around the country, which makes me feel smug and important.
Well, that's terrific, Mike, and I deeply appreciate you joining us. It's Mike Rowe who's joining us. Somebody's got to do it. You cannot miss this. An Anthony Bourdain show is equally as entertaining on CNN. It's interesting watching CNN morph from a news channel to an entertainment channel, and Mike, you're doing a great job over there. Thanks so much for joining us. Mike Rowe, Somebody's Got to Do It, and thanks for joining us again.
Thanks, Lee, anytime. I appreciate it.
You bet.